Well, thank you very much, everybody. My name is Jim Webb. I'm the general manager of Manifest Distilling. We're an organic distillery in downtown Jacksonville. We're very craft. We've had a very interesting 2020. We probably made more hand sanitizer than vodka, but in 2021, we're going to be talking to you tonight about making some cocktails, which you have gotten in this kit, with our citrus vodka. It's going to be a very simple cocktail, no shaking, no stirring, and we're going to do a classic mule with a twist. So first off, what we have to do is every mule needs a lime. So we're going to cut up our lime. And we're going to add some ice to our glass. Ice doesn't come in your kit, it would have melted by now. We're going to put a piece of lime on the edge. We're going to be adding some citrus vodka to it. What's interesting about this citrus vodka versus other flavored vodkas is that what we do is we put the lemon, orange, and grapefruit peels in a batch of our potato vodka and let that sit for about 3 days. And that basically the alcohol dissolves the oils and the skins. So when you smell this, to me, it smells like that zest, like that little oomph when you open up, a piece of citrus. And as opposed to other vodkas where they add juice and sugar and all that, this has the same calories and the same actual amount of alcohol as a regular vodka, because we distill it a second time after that. So we have our vodka in our glass, and we're going to add some ginger beer. And then what I like to do with this, just to make it a little extra citrusy, is add some cube grapefruit soda to the drink. And cheers, here's to another heroes.
Hi everybody, I'm Jen.
And I'm Jamie.
And we're with the Chef's Garden Catering Events and Jen and Jamie's virtual cooking classes. And we just want to say thank you so much for including us in tonight's UF Health's Night of Heroes.
We truly hope y'all are enjoying your partinis in the comfort of your own home. And we thank you for your support from the bottom of our hearts.
And that has been the silver lining for us this year, is just the opportunity to find new ways to connect with our community. So partinis and meal delivery is one. Our virtual cooking classes are another. And if you haven't had a chance to join us for one of our cooking classes, we hope that you will soon. We actually have a great one for Valentine's Day next week. So you can find more information at cateringjacksonville.com. But tonight, cheers to an awesome organization, and hoping you're having a great time.
Cheers, y'all.
A very good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the UF Health Heroes Gala pre-show. I am Aaron Bean, and I'm coming to you live from the Perry McCall Construction Studios, and what a wonderful show that we have in store for you tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm looking at my watch. We are 12 minutes away from this gala that is a little bit different, as you can already imagine, ladies and gentlemen. But COVID has changed the way that we do business with our galas, but the demand for UF Health continues, and we just know that it's there for us. So ladies and gentlemen, you're 12 minutes away, but there's still plenty of time to get ready for the show, including registering. If you haven't registered and are watching right now, on the bottom of your screen is to text UF Health Heroes to 72727, and then your cell phone will magically light up. We'll give you a link to keys to the show to bid, to participate, and see all the good things happening. There are three items, though, ladies and gentlemen, that I want to bring your attention to. These are our most popular items that we've had in the past, and they're back better and bigger than ever. Our first is auction item 801. It's the Players Package. Thank you, Players, for making this happen. These are patio tickets, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know if you know this. The Players is selling limited tickets this year, so you want to get yours early. And not just any ticket, this patio ticket, ladies and gentlemen, has special seating and reserved areas where you can get in on all the action. The 17th green, the 16th tee box, and even holes 12 and 13. And then on the patio, unlimited wine and beer. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a $2,000 package. And as I look at my phone, current bid is at $750. So check that out. And back again, ladies and gentlemen, it's the Casa Mia yacht brought to you by Haskell. Thank you so much, Haskell, for donating the Casa Mia once again. So ladies and gentlemen, you and 15 guests are going to climb aboard the Casa Mia leaving Ortega and then on a mutually agreed upon date. And here's the best part. The best part about this package, you get to bring your own food and drink. How about that? You know, bring your favorite because it's welcome. And so on a mutually agreed upon date, the Casa Mia set sail for a 3-hour tour. What could go wrong? No, you're going to have a great time and enjoy the lights of the city of Jacksonville. Ladies and gentlemen, that is on sale right now. It's only $1,150 right now. So check that out. It's item 802. And then how about this? Priceless. A priceless bucket list item for many of fans of UF Health Jacksonville is a rod on Trauma One. A rod, you and a guest will enjoy a rod on Trauma One to see breathtaking views and heart-pounding views of downtown Jacksonville, the St. John's River. This is not for sale anywhere else other than tonight. You can't go and buy this. So if you have a bucket list to ride on Trauma One, we would love to have you bid on that. Right now, that package is priceless. $750 will put you on the board to get it going. The only restrictions there is you got to be 18 or over, and it's after COVID. So after COVID, you'll be first in line to take a ride on Trauma One on a mutually agreed upon date. I see you out there, Darnell Smith. Thank you so much for watching. I see the Carol and Lindsay Brock. Thank you for tuning in. We got so many great things in store for you, including our CEO, Dr. Leon Haley. I passed him in the green room, and he's about to come on in just a few minutes. And then we've got a star-studded lineup, including Kent Justice, who's going to be your official host as we get things going. So right now, ladies and gentlemen, 8 minutes to showtime. It's time to go fill up your favorite beverage, get in your favorite cozy chair. And thank you. I see you, Wayne McCall. Thank you so much for being our big sponsor once again, Perry McCall Construction. So in 7 minutes, this show is going to be on the road. We're glad that you're here. Stay tuned as the 14th annual UF Health Jacksonville's Hero Gala is about to get going. See you in just a few minutes.
And good evening and welcome to everyone to tonight's broadcast of the 14th annual A Night for Heroes Gala. I'm Kent Justice. I'm a news anchor here in our area for WJXT Channel 4. We are the local station, and local events like this are the bread and butter of what we do. We're so excited to be part of what's happening tonight. We are live from Sight and Sound Studios here in Jacksonville, Florida. So tonight, I'm honored to join you in celebrating tonight the healthcare workers who are on the front lines, saving lives and caring for our community amid the ongoing coronavirus pandemic. The medical teams who care for patients and their families, they are the true heroes right now in our lives. It's our pleasure to pause tonight. We're going to honor them for the extraordinary work that they do each and every day, but especially what they have endured over the course of these last 11 months. As you know, this event typically focuses on one story, one incredible story about our city's most important resources, the region's only level one adult and pediatric trauma unit, UF Health Trauma One. So tonight we're going to share the story of a young man who was paralyzed while practicing gymnastics, and we're going to share his story of a remarkable recovery. And for the first time ever, we're going to recognize all the healthcare heroes, including the many individuals working behind the scenes at UF Health Jacksonville. We've got a full lineup for you, so don't go anywhere unless it's to refill your drinks while you're enjoying from home or your office. All right, so coming up tonight, A Night for Heroes. Here's what to expect. Dr. Leon L. Haley Jr., the CEO of UF Health Jacksonville, he's gonna join us live. Hear the story of a trauma patient, Jordan McClinton, who, well, you're gonna see where he is today, and you're gonna hear what he and his family have to say to the caregivers at UF Health who have been lifesavers for him. And later in our show, you're going to have a chance to help purchase life-saving equipment for UF Health Jacksonville. And here's the big deal. You see at the bottom of the screen, if you're not already registered for QTAGO, please do that right now. You follow the instructions at the bottom of the screen. You text on your mobile phone. You text UF Heroes, and it's pretty easy. You just do that to 72727. All right. Right now, a quick word from our presenting sponsor, Perry McCall Construction, Inc.
Hi, I'm Carson McCall. On behalf of Perry McCall Construction, we'd like to thank the heroes past and present of UF Health. It's a privilege to be part of tonight's event because we get to honor the heroes who give hope to our community when we're at our most vulnerable. Thank you for everything you do, and go Gators.
And thank you to our friends at Perry McCall Construction, Inc. The McCalls, they've continued to demonstrate just really unparalleled commitment to UF Health Jacksonville and the patients that get served every day there. So in addition to Perry McCall, many of you, whether individuals or corporations or even nonprofit organizations, you support the cause and the mission as sponsors and donors. So a sincere thanks to you, the presenting sponsor, Perry McCall Construction, Inc. The Golden Hour sponsor is Stellar. Dedication sponsors tonight, Brooks Rehabilitation, Crothall Healthcare. Champion sponsors are Batson Cook Construction, Danis Construction, Gresham Smith, Miller Electric Company, MedTrans Corporation. Hero sponsors tonight, Ascension St. Vincent's, Century Ambulance, Charles Perry Partners, Inc., Florida Blue, and Pagic and Pagic. And the Lifesaver sponsors, Russ and Susan Armstead, the Fiorentino Group, Dr. Leon L. Haley Jr., McKim and Creed, Inc. Thank you to each of the sponsors for what's happening tonight. And right now, I'd like to introduce you to and bring to the set Dr. Leon L. Haley Jr. Dr. Haley, serving as both CEO of UF Health Jacksonville and Dean of the College of Medicine Jacksonville. He's also Vice President for Health Affairs at the University of Florida, and he's a full professor. And you may know that UF Health Jacksonville was selected as one of the first five health systems to receive vaccine supply across the entire state of Florida, and will have fully vaccinated 11,000 people by the time everyone receives their second dose later this month. UF Health Jacksonville in Northeast Florida, they've been fortunate to have his calm leadership through such a tough time and guiding us through the pandemic. So welcome, Dr. Haley.
Glad to be here, Kent, and good evening, everyone. Of course, we would much rather be gathering with all of you tonight in a beautifully decorated downtown hotel ballroom on the river. But despite the circumstances, we are truly thankful you have chosen to tune in and celebrating our healthcare heroes tonight. We'd like to say hello to our friends watching from Fernandina Beach to St. Augustine, Orange Park, Atlantic Beach, Memphis, Tennessee, Houston, Texas. Thank you all for showing your support for healthcare tonight, for UF Health tonight. It has been a tumultuous time, but I have to say the opportunity to work with other fellow hospital leaders, CEOs, supporters, and friends like all of you has been quite uplifting. The commitment to combating this virus is inspiring. And that phrase, we're all in this together, has been evidenced by the collaboration we have right here in our city. That includes our leadership at City Hall. Some of you may know Mayor Leonard Curry is a proud University of Florida graduate, and we are honored to have him with us tonight with a message of hope and thanks.
Hi, I'm Mayor Lenny Curry. It's my honor to welcome you to the 14th annual A Night for Heroes Gala. Like many events have been, this year's gala looks a bit different. As much as I'd love to see you all in person, I'm happy that we're able to gather virtually to honor those who have sacrificed and given so much to our community, and especially during this pandemic. As our region's premier academic medical provider, UF Health, and its amazing team of more than 6,200 faculty and staff provide critical services to the people of Jacksonville and the First Coast. That important role has been heightened with the rise of COVID-19, and this team really stepped up to aid in testing operations, treatment, and now the administration of the vaccine. I'm extremely grateful to all the heroes at UF Health for your incredible work on the front lines of this virus. I deeply appreciate your dedication and life-saving work supporting and caring for the people of our city. From the bottom of my heart, thank you. I wish you all a safe and healthy 2021 and hope to see everyone in person again next year.
And thank you, Mayor Curry, and for your leadership throughout this pandemic. So if you haven't yet, I want to remind you, sign up for the silent auction, and you can register to do that by texting UF Heroes. You do that to the number 72727. And now is the time to make any last minute bids on those silent auction items. The silent auction closes at 7:30. You've got a little bit of time. There's some great items on there. So go ahead and register and make your bids. All right, coming up next, a few messages from several patients who were honored at previous A Night for Heroes events. You may remember their stories, stories of recovery and perseverance. And we want you to hear how they're doing now and a word from some of the generous sponsors.
Hello, everyone. My name is Brian Lynn, and I was the 2017 Night for Heroes patient honoree. And just want to congratulate everyone in pulling off a Night for Heroes event in the midst of a pandemic. It's great to see the tradition continue. It's been 4 years since my traumatic brain injury, and I've had the opportunity to participate both as a sponsor and also attend the gala. And it really reinforces for me just how lucky I am to have been in the care of the heroes at UF Health. My health since the accident has never been better. I went from fighting for my life to doing the things I love with the people I love. And I owe all of that to the heroes at Trauma One and UF Health. So thank you all for your continued support and have a great time tonight.
As an architecture, engineering, and design firm, there are two sides to the work we do. The genuine side of building relationships and bettering communities, and the ingenuity side of solving problems and designing the future. It's when we combine our genuine approach with our design ingenuity that we're able to see the whole picture. The intricate details and the broader perspective. The contrast, then the complements. The horizontal and the vertical. The people and the process. The two sides that make us whole. Gresham Smith, genuine ingenuity.
Hey everybody, my name is Brett Parks. October 17th, 2012 is a day I'll never forget. I was in the United States Navy. I heard somebody off base being robbed and I intervened. The result of me being shot and left for dead. I was rushed to UF Health Trauma One Center, and because of the awesome doctors, nurses, and incredible equipment there, I was able to survive a 99.999% mortality rate. And because of all the great effort by all the doctors and nurses, I have accomplished so much since 2012, October 17th. I am a USA sitting volleyball player. I am a para bobsledder. I am a gold and silver medalist for Prince Harry's Invictus Games. I'm a published author, and I recently landed a guest starring role on Law & Order SVU on NBC. And back in 2013, when I was honored at Night for Heroes, I told you guys that I will earn what you gave to me. And every day of my life, I think about that, and I think about how hard you guys worked for me. So the least I can do is work hard for you. And I am continually trying to earn it, and I'm doing the best I can. Thank you all, you wonderful doctors, nurses, administration, and the awesome equipment that helped me survive. Thank you guys. Hope you have a wonderful night. Over and out.
When 2020 began, we had many plans. Plans to celebrate our 50 years of excellence in rehabilitation and caring for our community. Plans to break ground on a new inpatient rehabilitation hospital. But then we were struck by the worst global pandemic our generation has ever seen. However, as we quickly pivoted to confront this challenge head on, we saw something incredible. You. Through one of the most challenging years in modern history, you have risen above and gone beyond. You have shown what it means to come together for a common goal. You have defined what it means to be a team.
And you just heard part of it right there. In March 2020, the world changed, and we were forced to pivot instantly, forced in many cases to shift to work and school remotely. Restaurants and businesses closed. Elective procedures, they were canceled, and the caregivers at UF Health began gearing up to fight an unseen adversary. And when much of the world, the rest of the world anyway, was shutting down, you know, it's easy to forget that the emergencies, traumatic injuries, they didn't stop. While people with an option avoided the emergency department and doctor's offices for fear of contracting the virus, others couldn't wait. And the team at UF Health, they stood ready to provide unparalleled care. Now, tonight, we're proud to share with you the story of Jordan McClinton. Jordan is a Brunswick native. He's a student athlete at Georgia Tech. Like most college students, he returned home from campus in April due to the pandemic, and it was there where he found himself unexpectedly in need of care from the experts at UF Health Trauma One.
For Jordan McClinton, his dream had come true. An accomplished athlete, an amazing student, his life after high school in Brunswick was exactly what he had hoped for. An offer to join the cheerleading team at the school he always wanted to attend, Georgia Tech. For his parents, Vicky and Dominic, so much pride in Jordan and his brother. This was a family who, as they say, were blessed. But life as it will threw them a curveball that would take a monumental effort, not only from Jordan, but everyone around him, to push through. April 20th, 2020. Jordan and his mother remember the day, the exact time. That's when he was practicing gymnastics in the front yard. But during his routine, something devastating happened. Practicing on wet grass, Jordan slipped and didn't get completely through a flip. He landed awkwardly on his head, injuring his neck and spine.
I remember it, but it doesn't really feel like it happened. It kind of feels like a movie. Every time I talk to my friends about it, it kind of feels like I was retelling a dream or retelling a movie that I watched.
I heard this sound and I couldn't put my finger on what it was. And I called for Jordan and he didn't answer. So I got up. So of course I ran out and I saw him there. Went and talked to him, told him I was going back in the house to call the paramedics.
And the paramedics who showed up knew exactly what to do once they saw the video Jordan had recorded of his routine.
They immediately went into action. You know, we're gonna have to have him airlifted, you know, it's bad. We have to take him to a trauma center, just, you know, it was like clockwork. They just sprung into action.
The next step was clear. Get Jordan to a place where he would get the immediate, crucial care he needed to stabilize and eventually to recover. That place, like it is for so many, was UF Health Jacksonville.
It was truly a godsend for him to end up at UF, and we are truly blessed that we went there to UF.
UF Health Trauma One picked Jordan up in Brunswick, and not long after, he was in the region's only level one trauma center, getting expert care from the trauma team.
Spinal cord injuries are devastating. Obviously, you know, the loss of the ability to move and breathe on your own is really challenging. Fortunate, he was brought to UF Health, where we really specialize in spinal cord injury care and have a comprehensive program with our neurosurgeons, our therapists. We even offer technology that Jordan really did benefit from that's not offered at most trauma centers.
It didn't take long for the trauma team to know exactly what Jordan needed. Get him to surgery, stabilize his spine, and then begin the slow process of recovery. But Dominic knew he was in the right place.
We wish that this would not have happened, but so many blessings have come from it actually happening.
They assured us that he was going to be in the best place and that they knew what they were doing. So they gave us comfort in knowing that. From talking to us every step of the way to treating us as if it was their son that they were caring for.
Always them being there, making sure I was comfortable, making sure I had everything I needed.
He's going to be okay. The people here are going to take care of him while we're here, and they absolutely did. To all of the nurses and the doctors that came through, they were tremendous.
After immediate surgery, Jordan was taken to UF Health Jacksonville's Pediatric Intensive Care Unit. Joe Tucker is the unit's nurse manager. The McClintons remember him well.
When you tell them you're uncomfortable, what is uncomfortable?
It was just my neck.
Your neck?
He made sure mom and dad were taken care of too.
We've got a great team of physicians, surgeons, nurses that do the primary care, but I ensured I checked on the family every day. Jordan has a great family. They're a great support system, and he had a great attitude. He had a great attitude, so I really think that helped in his recovery.
Whatever the needs were from Jordan's perspective, to Vicky and I, you need to make sure that you're taking care of yourself. You can't help him if you're not taken care of. So it immediately lifted a weight off of our shoulders and knowing that he's going to be okay.
Dominic says he knew Jordan would be okay when he was taken off a ventilator. But for mom and dad, it was a restless 2 weeks at UF Health. That's where Dr. Yorgaitis and the trauma team, Dr. Ghazanfar Ramathula and the neurosurgery team, and Joe and his nursing and support staff made sure Jordan received the expert care he needed to move to the next step. There were also dozens of other dedicated staff members, not only physicians and nurses, but rehabilitative and speech specialists, support staff, and so many more. The next phase would be in his home state of Georgia, in Atlanta, at the Shepherd Center. And by the way, that's close to Georgia Tech, where Jordan was determined to get back to. Jordan's recovery began on a table, but the little things kept him and the family going.
Do it again.
No!
Do it again.
From something as simple as moving his toes.
Mama!
It did, Jordan.
To standing with the help of his care team.
Push.
Walking with the help of support equipment.
Better.
Taking steps down the hallway with the help of a walker.
Squeeze.
Then crutches. One step at a time. The process took months. Vicky stayed with Jordan at first. Because of COVID, she couldn't leave and no one else could come in. Then when Jordan was ready for outpatient rehab, it was Dominic's turn.
Sorry, you're getting it.
Mom for comfort, dad to push in during rehab. And along the way, plenty of support. Well wishes from friends back home. a message from another former Heroes honoree, Tim Callahan, who recovered from a similar spinal injury.
He's completed his goal of walking out of circle.
And just a few months after first coming to UF Health, Jordan was leaving rehab at Shepherd, on crutches, but on his own.
Jordan, I'm really amazed. I know you had a great attitude about this. You worked hard, and I'm so proud of you. I'm proud of you. You've got a great support system, and I'm sure that played a major impact on your recovery.
Get it, Jordan!
Couldn't have asked for a better staff to help us get through this situation.
You're amazing. You are amazing. I appreciate everything that you've done. What you do is a passion, it's a calling. And I thank you, as Jordan mentioned, from the bottom of our hearts. If it wasn't for what you did, Jordan wouldn't be here today.
It truly saved my life. At the time, I probably couldn't have seen it or understood what was happening. But now looking back at it, I really thank you for all that you did and really cared about everything that happened to me. And I appreciate that.
That is an amazing and inspirational story. And how about this? Earlier this week, Jordan and his family had a chance to reunite with some of those healthcare workers and people who were his caregivers at UF Health Jacksonville. We are grateful to Jordan and his family for allowing us to share his story. And there's one other great part to this. Jordan returned to campus at Georgia Tech just last month. That is an incredible accomplishment. And Jordan, we wish you and your family all the best. All right, so ladies and gentlemen, don't forget the auction closes. That's coming up at 7:30 at the bottom of your screen. Again, instructions on how you can be registered, how you can be bidding on those items. Get your last minute bids in now. All right, so Dr. Haley, I want to bring you back in as I throw it back to you. Imagine moments like those with Jordan McClinton. Those have to be the reason for the enormous sense of pride that you have in your staff at UF Health Jacksonville.
Absolutely, and what a remarkable story. Thank you, Kent, and you are right. I am so deeply proud of all of our nearly 8,000 employees for their perseverance. They are part of this amazing, beautiful symphony, this orchestra that takes place when each of us play our part in the role of caring for others. I want to start by thanking all of you out there for spending your Saturday night with us as we gather to honor and thank our nurses, our physicians, healthcare providers. Among special events, this is distinctive. This year in particular is one we will never forget as we gather in our homes through the use of technology in order to prevent the spread of COVID-19. But it's been a year, hasn't it? For us as a nation, for our community, for our families, when we were planning our 150th anniversary in 2019, we could have never imagined what was coming, how we'd be tested as an organization, how we'd be tested as a society. Could we commit to our mission to heal, to comfort, to educate, to discover in these the worst of times? These tenets of our mission statement are tried. As individuals, we became weary, but our colleagues stepped in when we needed to rest. We had to give and take and ask for help when we felt like quitting. We made sacrifices, carried on through adversity and fear. Many would say they were just doing their jobs, but we are now well over 300 days with our incident hospital command center open and activated, and these heroes behind the mask work together tirelessly day in and day out. They went out into the community to provide testing to seniors and the medically underserved, adopted telehealth in their practice, saved more than 1,000 COVID patients and hundreds of others who came in with other ailments. We vaccinated nearly 11,000 seniors and fellow healthcare workers, and they continue to do it quietly without much fanfare. They have remained committed to inclusion, diversity, equity, and access. They are brave. And if you are like me, you look for silver linings in times like these. It's been powerful to see the community and frankly the world gain a new appreciation for healthcare workers. You heard about it in New York, in Italy, where they cheered for them from their balconies and windows and tacked up colored paper hearts to show appreciation on their windows and their doors. Many of you tuning in came forward and gave us energy with donations of food and banners, video messages, encouraging us to keep the faith and financial support that helped fuel our work. Let me say this, just as an audience applauding provides validation to performing musicians, your support meant the world to us. In my 31 years of practicing emergency medicine, I can honestly say you came through when we needed you the most, and I thank you. At last year's event, we highlighted our ECMO program, a form of life support for patients with heart and lung failure, shared the patient stories of Brandon Taylor and our own Dr. Louis Rios, and raised critical funds to maintain equipment and train our staff. ECMO is considered a last resort, an innovative, incredible approach to offering one last bit of hope. Little did we know just how timely that message would be. ECMO was a tool we relied upon to fight even coronavirus, another reminder that you never know when you may need life-saving care. But tonight, I'm asking you for your support of another critical device used to care for both trauma and COVID-19 patients, something you've all become familiar with in the past year, ventilators. Whether deployed in our hospitals or high above in our helicopters, these can be the difference between life and death. We hope you'll reflect on the impact this life-saving equipment had on mothers and grandmothers and care providers across the world this year, and hope that you will make a gift that is meaningful and generous. At this time, I'm proud to recognize the collective efforts of every person across our enterprise for their valiant efforts. It takes each and every individual doing their part to save lives. It is my privilege to be their leader and to work alongside them to carry out the important work of our mission and our vision. Please join me in thanking all of our heroes. This tribute is for our UF Health Jacksonville heroes behind the mask. Thank you.
Dr. Haley, thank you for introducing that. And we'd also like to offer our thanks to the healthcare workers at other health institutions and healthcare places here in Jacksonville, as well as to the caregivers in assisted living facilities, first responders, essential workers, and teachers. Thank you to all of you. We're really thankful about all you do to keep our community loved and safe, and our loved ones, keeping them safe and strong. So, ladies and gentlemen, now's our chance to show some gratitude, and we've got some great help to do that. We're going to show gratitude by giving generously tonight and support the mission. I'd like to welcome to the show Senator and the President pro tempore of the state of Florida Senate, the honorable, the always entertaining, Aaron Bean. Glad to have you here.
Kent Justice, thank you so much. Always a pleasure to be with you. I feel very fortunate to be here tonight, just as we all are fortunate to have UF Health Jacksonville and UF Health Trauma One right here in our city. But it serves the whole region, ladies and gentlemen, Northeast Florida and Southeast Georgia. Kent, you're right. It's time for the audience participation portion of the program, as we will ask each of you to help us raise critical funds to support life-saving equipment that Dr. Haley has already talked about, ventilators for our ICU and our Trauma One helicopters. I know you've heard it before and it's on your screen now. If you haven't registered, you can do it. Yeah. It's easy. UF Health Heroes, UF Heroes to 72727. Kent Justice, we are gonna fill a heart tonight. And when that heart is full, we're going to buy a ventilator.
How are we going to do that?
That's a great thing. There's that heart right there. And Kent Justice, I don't know what you and Dr. Haley did. I think it was Jordan Story who we were all in the back room trying not to cry, how proud we were of Jordan and the team of support that got him. But ventilators are what's on everybody's mind right now. We hadn't really heard of them prior to the virus, but they're referred to as life support machines. Often used in intensive care for patients who cannot breathe on their own. Many of our sickest patients need the assistance of a ventilator to survive. It could be patients with respiratory illnesses like pneumonia, COVID, or patients with severe injuries like Jordan.
Yeah, and so this is something that many people didn't really understand until this last year, when we've heard about how important ventilators are. And so you know now a little bit about, ventilators, and it's about helping those COVID-19 patients, but other trauma patients as well. And so that's what we need your help about. So filling the heart here, we've got a big, hairy, audacious goal here about raising $50,000. And you see in the heart on the side of your screen there, we're up to almost $18,000 right now. We want you to keep the donations coming in here.
Yeah, Kent Justice, last year we had to beg, borrow, and ventilators. We didn't have enough. There were so many that in need. We're not going to do that this year. We are going to buy our own. In fact, we're going to buy the top of the line. How about that? So if you need it or a loved one needs it, if we ever need UF Health Jacksonville, it's going to be there with the newest technologies and modalities. It's going to be good. And Kent Justice, it's amazing because our job is we're over halfway there to our goal of $50,000.
We haven't done much yet. We've just given you the opportunity, but people like Betty Fenlon, Lisa Gormley, Wayne McCall, Jamie Root, all of you are giving right now. Alan Verlander on the list here as well. We are seeing you.
Jeannie Bradshaw jumped in. How about that? Lisa Gormley. Lindsey Brock, you were with us on the pre-show and you're still there. Thank you so much. Carolyn Blake. Shelly Boynton, how about that? Thank you, Shelly. She's part of the UF Health family as well as, in fact, everybody watching tonight, whether you're watching on your cell phone or
you get
or
to
computer,
be family.
Yeah, you're part of the UF Health family, Kent Justice. That's exactly right. Right now, we're just 18,500 away from that brand new ventilator.
So what I love is some of you are like, I might put a little in at the beginning and then I'll save my big donation for, go ahead, come on. Make that big donation now. Yep. And the other thing that's great, Andrew Smith, thank you. And Ton Hogan, thank you. Mike Metzler, thank you. As we get little bit gifts, whether that's a big gift, small gift, however you look at it, it all goes together to fill up this heart, which is going to be a big, big deal when we get to $50,000 and we're on the way.
That's exactly right. Karen Babcock, Anonymous, There's several anonymous donors tonight. Thank you, Anita Vining, Linda Lawson.
Anonymous is doing a good job. Anonymous is doing a good job.
Yeah, Anonymous is rocking tonight. And Kent, you nailed it, because in past Heroes events, people ask, will my little donation mean anything? Yeah. And it truly does. It bought the ECMO machine last year. And interesting enough, when you saw Jordan getting rehabbed, there was that contraption where it was straps from the ceiling. It's called a solo step. And if anybody will remember from, I think it was 3 or 4 years ago, that was our featured item. Little did we know what a difference it would make. It was in Jordan's life for all the folks that have used it. My time here is almost done, Kent Justice, because we're just, $7,200 away. I think we're going to leave it open. And Kent Justice, if you'll tell me when we hit 50 grand, bring us the breaking news.
I will.
That a new ventilator is on its way to UF Health Jacksonville.
Well, we might all be on the breaking news circuit and desk tonight to announce that. But we're at 43,000 right now. We're trying to get to 50,000, and know that we're going to keep this open. You can continue contributing as we go through the rest of our event here.
Kent Justice, thank you so much. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. What a true difference we're all making, one donation at a time.
So thank you for your generosity. And again, please continue giving throughout the night. And share this on your social networks. You can encourage others to invest in these heroes and the great work that's going on at UF Health Jacksonville. All right, so stay tuned. We're going to have messages now from a few more special guests. Gala chairs Amy Meyer and Aaron Yorgaitis. And the 2015 A Night for Heroes honoree, Tim Callahan.
Good evening, and thank you for joining us for the 14th annual A Night for Heroes Gala. On behalf of the Trauma One Heroes Council, we would like to thank you for your generous support of the event and your donations, which help us purchase life-saving equipment. The Council is proud to raise funds for UF Health Jacksonville and UF Health Trauma One, especially now, as our spouses, friends, and colleagues spend long hours testing, vaccinating, and taking care of patients with COVID in addition to their regular responsibilities. We have seen this firsthand in our personal life, and that is why Amy and I have volunteered our time to honor and celebrate all of you tonight.
We would like to thank all of the healthcare workers across the city, including my colleagues at the Department of Health, and especially those here at UF Health Jacksonville. But I would be remiss if I didn't thank those who have come to support us over all of these months, especially people like Aaron and my husband. Knowing that you are there taking care of our children, our parents, and our loved ones, and making sure that things are taken care of at home is a huge weight off our shoulders. Thank you to everyone here at UF Health who has been doing everything you can to fight this pandemic. Thank you for everyone who is joining us tonight, and we hope you are inspired by tonight's program.
What's going on, everyone? I'm here with my two little boys right now, and just wanted to give you guys a quick update on myself and what's going on with me and my foundation, actually. So this past year was actually 10 years from my accident. For those who don't know, I was paralyzed, broke my neck playing flag football, and was paralyzed from the neck down. And through the amazing doctors at UF Health, I was able to overcome all of that. And after being told I would never walk again, walking and doing everything I love, and was told that I would never have two little boys, and now I have these two amazing little boys. But we also have a foundation that we do free sports camps for kids. But yeah, just a quick shout out to all the doctors and nurses at UF Health for making this possible. Now I can tickle these crazy boys.
Yeah, that's a pretty amazing story that he has. Each of our honorees over the years gets to share with other people the way their lives have been affected for the better because of UF Health and Trauma One. So once again, we want to say thank you for your support this evening. Let's check back in and see how we're doing on the big fundraising goal here. We are almost there. We're filling up the heart here. We want to get to $50,000. We're almost at $45,000. One of you out there right now is thinking, I could probably just send in that $5,000 right now. I could just make that happen right now. Why not? We're trying to get ventilator for the care of people who are in need. So,
so close, Kent, Kent Justice, yep. So close. It's right there, and more donations are coming in. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
All right, so we want to thank you for your gifts, your support tonight. We want to thank those folks who have contributed to this vital work that Trauma One does to save lives. And to our heroes, tonight is for you. We see you. We appreciate you. We truly thank you for your bravery and your compassion, and especially this year, your resilience. Thanks again to our sponsors tonight, notably Perry McCall Construction, and to our chairs for the event, Amy Meyer and Aaron Yorgaitis, and the entire Trauma One Heroes Council. You made tonight possible when it could have seemed impossible. There was no such thing as impossible when it came to what we were trying to do tonight. Thank you for your creativity, your adaptability, ensuring that this year's show could go on in a time when UF Health needs our support the most. Like Jordan, our honoree tonight, like he said, we will continue to move forward together one step at a time. All right, so now for those of you who are at home, usually end this part of the evening by taking a short break and then coming out on the dance floor, and then we're rocking with the band or a DJ. So we're going to maintain some of that tradition. We're going to end on a musical note. It's been a hard year. We're all missing out on live music in most places. So here is an encore performance from the 2019 A Night for Heroes honoree, Chris Hemmen. And in the meantime, good night. We thank you for your support.
I'm Chris Hemmen. I was in a horrible car accident on July 23rd, 2017. The medical staff told my parents I wasn't going to make it through the night, but thanks to the UF Health doctors, nurses, and teams, I was able to make it through and to enjoy this wonderful thing called life. Since then, I was the 2019 Night for Heroes honoree. I graduated high school. I'm attending UNF and I'm on my second year, and I'm starting to become a mechanical engineer. To sum all that up, I'm driving, thriving, and surviving. The UF Health doctors and staff, I'll forever be grateful for you. A special thanks to the doctors and staff that still stays in touch. In particular, two members that attended my high school graduation, this is for you. Stay safe.
Thank you so much for joining us and your support tonight.
Thank you.
Good night. All right.